Hey everyone, you're watching Silly Science with Simon. My name is Simon and this is the ultimate guide to do-it-yourself lava lamps. You're probably wondering why I'm sitting on the table. I made so many lava lamps that the floor has turned into lava. You don't believe me? Check out the lava in this lava lamp. Are you ready to make one? Then let's get science. This is the ultimate guide to do-it-yourself lava lamps, so we're gonna need a few things. Vegetable oil, baby oil, tonic water, vinegar, bicarb soda, water, red cabbage, a highlighter, food coloring, alka-seltzers, dry ice, and an empty bottle. Do-it-yourself lava lamps have three parts, a lower layer, an upper layer, and an activator. To get started, we'll need to do some maths on an empty bottle. Measure the volume of the bottle, mine was 500 mils, and divide this by 3. Then round this down to the nearest multiple of 50. Add this amount of water to the bottle, along with 10 drops of food coloring. This will form our lower layer. Remember that number from before? You now need to double it and add that amount of vegetable oil to your bottle. This forms the upper layer. Oil and water don't mix with each other. Because the vegetable oil is less dense than the water, it sits on the top. Divide that magical number by 100 and add that number of Alka-Seltzer tablets. Break them into a few pieces first. This is our activator. Whoa, how cool does that look? Alka-Seltzers contain bicarb soda and citric acid, which react with each other to form carbon dioxide, just like in episode 7 and 14. As the carbon dioxide is formed, it rises to the surface, bringing some of the lower layer with it. When it reaches the surface, it drops the lower layer, which falls back to the bottom. Awesome! I'm now going to use a few different things for the lower layer, the upper layer, and the activator to see what works best. Let's go! Okay, here's the one that we just made. In this one, I've changed the food coloring from red to green. Now I've changed the food coloring from green to blue. This looks really nice. Instead of using water and food coloring, I'm now using red cabbage juice. You can see it starting to turn pink as the solution becomes acidic. I've now used tonic water as the bottom layer, which glows under a UV light. I might need to try this again at nighttime. And lastly, I've added the ink from a highlighter pen to some water. This also glows under a UV light, but it might look better at nighttime. That's all the different types of lower layers. I really liked how the blue one looked, so we'll use it for the next few lava lamps where we're gonna change the activator. So just a reminder, this is what the blue lava lamp looked like with vegetable oil and an Alka-Seltzer activator. Now I'm going to use a piece of dry ice as the activator. It also forms carbon dioxide gas, which rises to the surface, bringing some of the lower layer with it. I really like how this looks. In this one, I've placed 1 tablespoon of bicarb soda, 2 teaspoons of water, and then I've added the vegetable oil. When I pour the vinegar in, it should... Oh no! Let's try adding that a bit slower. There we go, that looks a lot better, but this one is a bit too risky. Up to now, we've been using vegetable oil as the upper layer. Let's see what it looks like with baby oil instead. The blue water seems to be dropping really quickly when it reaches the top. I might need to try adding 2 pieces of dry ice. Okay, that still doesn't look as good as the vegetable oil. It's cool, but it's not as cool. Earlier, it was a bit too hard to see the tonic water and highlighter pen glowing under the UV light. That's because there was way too much sunlight. Plus, the vegetable oil made it a little bit too hard to see. I'm gonna try it again at nighttime using baby oil instead. Here I've used water with ink from a highlighter pen as my lower layer. You can definitely see it glowing a lot better. And here I've used tonic water as my lower layer. This one looks awesome and is my favorite one under a UV light. My overall favorites were the blue water, vegetable oil, and dry ice for during the day, and the tonic water, baby oil, and dry ice for at nighttime under the UV light. If you try this at home, make sure you share a photo with me on Instagram by tagging me at Silly Science with Simon. I hope you enjoyed this episode and I'll see you again in 2 weeks. Now, how do I get out of here?